summer. What? It's a DJ, keep on playing summertime sadness. After you go to the bathroom, can we go smoke a cigarette? I really need one. But first, let me take a selfie.
It's recording, right? What's up, lovely people? Welcome to another episode, man. What's up? What's up, lovely people? Welcome to another episode. My name is Perry. So this is Tech Talk. And if you're on social media, I'm positive that you've been seeing a lot of Oraimo products. Oraimo. I don't know how it's pronounced now. But basically, these people are just permeating the market and they are doing amazing stuff. If you check on their websites, they have power banks, they have smart watches, they have trimmers, they have electrical gadgets, like a lot of things. And they are, I think currently I even saw a blender. I was like, hey, I mean, in no time they'll be bringing out phones. Who knows? They have sound bars, yeah, which I've tested before. Quality stuff. So recently I got some for myself. I just wanted to try that ecosystem and see. And I was impressed, honestly speaking. I did an unboxing of the Oraimo Riff, and then which is the earbuds or AirPods, so to speak. And the other one, which is the Oraimo Tempo S2, which is the smartwatch fitness tracker. So yes, in this particular episode, I'm going to be doing a full hands-on review of the Oraimo Riffs. So without wasting my time, let's jump right in. If you're in a relationship with somebody you lie agency for the past step, do not. I just hope nobody punches me in the face. Welcome back. So if you're a creative like myself, definitely you need earpiece. You need an earpiece, you need an earbud, you need an AirPod, whichever it is, however I want to say, even headset, you need something like that to be able to get out the best quality that you are looking for. So most of us, we just jump onto the Boses, the Sonys, the JBL, etc. Until Oraimo came into the picture. So I got myself the Oraimo Riff, and as you can see, it's here. It's very, very nice. I wouldn't lie. So I'm going to be doing a full hands-on review, like I said earlier. And please, if you haven't yet, do what to subscribe. It's very, very important. It goes a long way to support us as creators, and so that we can be able to get you more content like this one. So I'm going to be breaking down the whole review process into 7 major categories. So let's jump onto the first one, which is the packaging. To be honest, when it comes to the packaging, it's nice. I wouldn't lie, it's very, very nice. The box itself, the branding, the colors, the font styles, the combinations, is just very, very impressive. Very, very impressive. And if you pull it out like this, love it. It comes in this box, Adam and Eve box. So you just have to slide one off the other. Yes, and then you find yourself with an actual gadget that we are all looking for. It's very small, it's very compact, and it's doable. It fits in the palms. It's very, very nice, I wouldn't lie. When you go deeper, you're going to meet some paperworks, your cable charging. And another good thing is, I'm going to jump onto that particular one later, which is the hardware. But there are some paperworks, some cable charges, basically that. It's very durable, very, very durable. Very, very durable, I wouldn't lie. And the packaging is nice, honestly speaking. The brand is out there, the colors are everything is merging beautifully. So that's something that you should be expecting when you get yourself one. The next category has to do with the hardware, and this is all you get, basically speaking. This is all you get. This is it. When you open it, you have your buds in there. This is all you get. And one good thing I like is that they added is it Q-tips or ear tips, butt tips, whatever. So they added about 3 of them. So you have medium, small, and large. So if your ears are smaller, if your holes are smaller, holes are smaller, you have a smaller Q-tips. If they are medium, you have that one as well. If they are large too, you have that one as well. And it's very integral, because the quality of sound you're going to be getting depends on how well you insert the device into your ears. So that's something you should take notice of. It's very small. I must say, it's very, very small. It's like, this is it. That's all there is. Very, very small. Pairing is not difficult. It fits for iOS. It fits for Android as well. For laptops, any other tablets, it fits. Everything fits. I've tested for Android and then iOS, and they fit perfectly. Yeah, good. The next one is the durability. At this juncture, I don't have the privilege. Not privilege, but I don't have the freedom. Shut up, I'm not talking to you. So at this juncture, I can't just drop it or throw it away or used to hit something and use that to determine the durability. But I've been using it for about 10 days, I should say. And I put it in my pocket. Other stuff are hitting it, pressing it. I put it in my bag. It's still durable. I've not seen scratches so far. I've not seen marks or any huge defects so far. I think it has fallen a couple of times from off the desk, and I've not seen anything tangible like that. So I can't say it is durable, but it doesn't mean you should be throwing it away and then doing catch and throw, that kind of thing. No, but as far as first use is concerned, it is very, very durable. Now, the battery runtime. This is where I have a couple of issues, because it's not as much as they say. And I think on the box they say it can give you up to 4.5 hours on a single charge. Now, I tried to listen to some good music on full volume, and it lasted approximately 3 hours and some minutes. So yes, maybe if you reduce your volume, you can have extended play. But if you're looking for full volume, you want to get really immersive, then you are not going to get the full 4.5 hours of runtime. But another good thing is the case can give you about 3 or 4 more charges. So that is something you should be looking up to, because that's something you should be looking up to. The budget. I can't say it's very, very budget friendly, because this is about approximately 250 Ghana cedis only. And for active noise cancellation, for this durability, for this portability, I think it's worth it. It's worth it if you're looking for a budget-friendly AirPods or earbuds to use. So I think this is more in tune with the AirPods than earbuds. So if you're looking for a budget-friendly one to get yourself in your day-to-day activities, then definitely you should consider this, because it's a good thing. And the next thing is the versatility. Yeah, like I said earlier, it fits for laptops, Android, tablet, iOS, for all platforms. You just have to go to your Bluetooth settings, and then you find it there. You can also rename it if you want to name it maybe Perry's Oraimo Riff. You just do that, and it can easily pair with any device. The last category has to do with aesthetics. And with that, if I'm grading it out of 10, I'm going to give it like a very good 8, an easy 8, because the branding, the name itself is not all over the place. It's very small, centered. If you open it, you have your earbuds neatly placed. They are not too conspicuous. They are not too small. They don't have a lot of information that are overshadowing the major things that you're looking for. So it's nice. It looks pleasing to the ear. And if you're holding this, people can easily mistake it for an actual Apple AirPods. So it sticks very good. Conclusive judgment. I must say, like I said earlier, if you're looking for a budget-friendly AirPods to get you running in your day-to-day affairs, then this is a good one. Very, very budget-friendly. 250 cedis only. It's very good. It's very good. You should get it. If you ask me, I'll tell you, you should get it, because the sound quality is good. I did a couple of tests with the classical music. I did, the normal Afrobeats, Nigerian music, Burna Boy, Davido. I tried all of them, and the quality is good. And like I said, you have to work on your Q-tips. You have to know which one fits for you. because it's going to determine how good the quality that you're going to be getting. If it's too big, you may not be able to get it, but if it's medium and it fits perfectly, then you can enjoy that active noise cancelling as well as high bass. The sound quality is very good. It's rich, it has a balance, and it's a very balanced blend of the trebles and the bass. So it's good. So if you should get it, I would say yes. And you can check in the link in my bio if you want one for yourself. And I got it with the Twin Brother, which is the Oraimo Tempo S2. And I'm going to be doing a full hands-on review for that one as well. So if you haven't yet subscribed, please do all to do so. And then turn on the notification icon so you don't miss out on any new content that we release. And my name is Perry. I'm going to catch you on the next one. Until then, adios.